गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास 9 एंड वेलकम टू द ज्योग्राफी क्लास। इन द लास्ट क्लास वी वर स्टडिंग चैप्टर 4 जियोमॉर्फिक प्रोसेसेस एंड लैंडफॉर्म्स ऑफ अर्थ एंड वी हैड ऑलरेडी स्टडीड द प्लेट टेक्टोनिक थ्योरी, फोल्ड माउंटेन्स एंड वोल्केनिक माउंटेन्स। वी हैड स्टडीड दैट द फोल्ड माउंटेन्स आर फॉर्म्ड ड्यू टू द डाइवर्जेंस एंड कन्वर्जेंस ऑफ टेक्टोनिक प्लेट्स। However, volcanic mountains are formed due to the eruption of lava and solidifying of the lava on the Earth's surface. Due to this deposition, it creates a huge mountain known as volcanic mountains. So today we are going to study block mountains. We'll study that how, what are block mountains are, how and how are they formed. So block mountains are formed when tectonic plates or rock beds, if not tectonic plates are huge, then and block mountains are not so huge. So how are they formed? When rock beds, what happens, they move away from each other, then the land between the two rock beds, what happens, it sinks. Let me make you understand with the help of this demonstration. So block mountains are formed when cracks or faults occur in the earth's crust, just like this, and the land between the cracks sinks, leaving the upstanding blocks on either side. Now this is exactly how block mountains are formed. What happens, suppose this is a huge rock bed, this is a huge piece of land, nothing, just a piece of land. So what happens, cracks start to occur in two places such as this place and this place. Then what happens, the land in between these two rock beds, what happens, it starts to sinks. Now when this sinks, this land automatically becomes elevated in front of this. So this part, these two blocks of rocks that is upstanding, they are only known as block mountain or fault block mountains. They are also known as fault block mountains. In order to understand the formation of block mountains, you can do this illustration at your home. You'll take an eraser and then make lines on it on either side, and then cut the erasers from there. Now when you cut the erasers, they separate and put them back. And then what you do, hold the sides and lift the eraser up. When you lift the eraser up and slowly loosen it, what happens? The eraser in between, it sinks down. Now the eraser on either side, which is left elevated after the eraser in the middle sinks, what happens? This eraser on the either side uplifted, these are known as block mountains. So please copy from here till here, and this is the definition and formation that you can write in exam. You can also follow your book and you can also write this definition, this explanation, if this is easy for you. And for the better understanding of yourself, please draw this diagram. Now coming to this diagram, when a block mountain is formed, landforms like this are formed, and a land which has sinked down and a land which has been uplifted. Now the land which is uplifted is called a block mountain, or it is also called a horst. What is it called? H-O-R-S-T, horst. And the land which has sink in the ground due to the cracks and faults occurring on the earth's surface, those lands are called rift valley. As in your book, it says, a block of land between two parallel faults may sometimes rise up on either side and slide down below. The upstanding land masses are called block mountain or a horst, and the land which has sink, when a block is thrown down between two parallel faults, a rift valley or a graben is formed. In simple language, the uplifted blocks are termed as horst, and the lowered blocks are called as graben. So block mountains are all about blocks. The part which has sunk in the ground is also a block, and the part which has been uplifted is also a block. So the part which has sunk down is known as rift valley or graben, and the part which has been uplifted is called a block mountain or a horst. Now these are the Vosges block mountains in France, and this is the most important example of block mountains in the whole world. This shows a perfect example of what is a block mountain. Now as you can see, block mountains, they have flat tops and steep edges. The edges are steep, however the flat, they are top. These are the mountains of in Jabalpur. These are the marble rocks of Jabalpur. They are also an example of important block mountains which are present in India. Now coming to the features, I already told you that block mountains have flat tops and steep edges. Now these are known as steep edges, on which it is very difficult for someone to climb. However, the tops are flat like this and not like the fold mountains. The tops of fold mountains are conical. However, the tops of block mountains, they are flat. The next, these mountains are not as high as fold mountains and do not cover more area than fold mountains. Now, these block mountains are just formed due to the cracks that occur in the earth, on the rock bed of the earth or the earth's surface. So these mountains are not so high, such as the fold mountains, which are formed due to the crashing of tectonic plates. Now next, a river is always present in the rift valley. Now the land which has sunk down into the ground, which is also known as a rift valley, is always accompanied by a river. Wherever, now it is called a rift valley, and inside the rift valley there is a river always present. These are the three features that you can learn, and you don't have to learn any more features of this, because I feel that these are the only three features that are important. And the last feature in your book is also important, which says the sides of the block mountains are exposed to weathering, and so they usually get modified in their shapes and sizes. So these sides of block mountains, which are now very steep, they can also become very gentle. They can also become gentle throughout the years due to the process of weathering and erosion. So this was all about block mountains. So if you have any confusion, then please feel free to email me at this email account. So that will be all for today, and I'll see you in the next class. And in the next class, we'll be starting with residual or relict mountains.